Sharing the sun's gift, this woman, Mother Gothel, hoarded its healing power and used it to keep herself young for hundreds of years. And all she had to do was sing a special song.
Flower, gleam, and glow. Let your power shine. Make the clock reverse. Bring back what once was mine. What once was mine.
All right, you get the gist. She sings to it, she turns young. Creepy, right?
All those days watching from the windows, all those years outside looking in. Suddenly I see, standing here, it's all so clear, I'm where I'm meant to be. And at last I see the light, and it's like the fog has lifted. And at last I see the light, and it's like the sky is new.
Good day, everyone. I'm Shaira Siipis, a fourth-year Bachelor of Elementary Education student at Lagos Oriental State University, Shatun Campus. And welcome back to our new episode of Learning. This is my performance task 5, my personal shield. In today's video, I am characterized as Mother Gothel. Mother Gothel is a vain old woman who hoards the strong healing to live for many, many years and to remain perpetually young and beautiful. With the flower is harvested to the hill, the kingdom's ailing queen. Its powers are inheritedly with the king and the queens. Daughter Rapunzel, removing Gothel's access, with her life suddenly endangered. Gothel kidnapped the infant, imprisoning the princess in an isolated tower for 18 years while posing as her mother to exploit her powers. And she has a personal of extrovert thinking, extrovert sensing, extrovert intuition, and extrovert feeling. Life is short and in a world of chaos, social media, and divisiveness, precious things can easily become lost. We all have different needs and priorities in life, but we share the absence of certain things in life, causing us to feel no who we are. While our lives and priorities may differ, there are some vital to living a life of fulfillment and things we need to in our lives. As I begin, the first and the most important people that I have made in my life, and I never lose sight of these five essential things in my life, is my grandmother, my mother, my father, brothers and sisters, and also the love of my life. They are there to support my needs and cheering me up with deep studying. The most beautiful mall that I have visited even though life is unpredictably unpredictable. The part of my personality which I am very proud of is, even though life circumstances force me to become very strong and independent at a young age, I grew up in a home where I saw things that children should not ever see. Through this, I noticed how my parents had a few personal distractions, issues of their own to deal with. They were loving towards me and did the best to provide, but there were some gaps that I had to cover on my own, and there was lots of responsibility to fend for myself from early on. Being proud of yourself is more than just your career, but it's also the way you overcome certain setbacks and changing your perspective on things. It can also mean being proud of certain relationships and friendships you made and learning to stand up for yourself when it comes. If I was given 1 month to live, first of all, I would go to church during my 30 days of fasting, because church has always been part of my life. That is why I would spend my last days praising the Lord, because church is very important to me. It teaches me about the good and evil in life. I would go to church and make things right with my Lord and Savior. I would also pray to the Almighty, asking Him for forgiveness of all my sins, and I would thank the Lord for the life He has given me and all what I have accomplished. Lastly, I will spend my 30 days with my family, friends, and loved ones, enjoying myself, traveling, and having fun with my friends. And that could be all. Thank you for watching.
I'm where I'm meant to go.
And it's like the sky is blue.
And it's blue.